communion, of communion, of communion, of communion, of communion, of communion.
So I would like to share with you some, it's not about thoughts, but more about my personal experience being a pastor and also a business professor. So I also have had some admiration with that kind of people who has dreams about their future since they were kids. And then when they became adults, they fulfilled that dreams. Oh, I always dreamed to be a professor or a musician or a medical doctor, because I never have had that. So my life just keep going and things keep happening, and I was trying to understand what was happening and deal with that. And I never dreamed to be a professor, but here I am. So after 6 years, after my theological degree, I moved to a city in São Paulo, the province of São Paulo in Brazil, a city like Winnipeg with almost a million inhabitants, to plant a new church there. And it was a great experience, a successful experience as well. But that time I decided to get my second degree, and it was in social communication, journalism. And I was thinking to use that kind of skills at the church. And because of that, I was invited to move to São Paulo to start to implant and to run the marketing department of our bigger Presbyterian university there. So I was so excited because it would be my first job as a manager. And I was young, and I was thinking that could be a huge challenge for me, and it was. At the same time, I was invited to be an assistant pastor in a big church, Presbyterian church there. So for some years, I was doing both, teaching as a part-time at university. I skip an important part. I moved to São Paulo to start that department. And I decided to get my master's degree there. And I look for something related to communication. And at that time, they didn't have any degree in communication and master's degree. So the closest one was business. And I entered the business program. And after 1 year, still getting my master's degree, they invited me to start teaching at business school. But it was in the middle of the term, because the professor, due to professional issues, has quit, and they were looking for a new professor. The class was for 2 weeks long with no classes, because they didn't have a professor. So my guess is that they didn't find anybody. So they invited me to jump in and assume that class. And again, I thought it could be a challenge for me. And I accepted that job. And I was to teach about management theory, a subject that I never have saw before, because I didn't have any business background. So it was a challenge. And I also was invited to be assistant pastor. And for 7 years or more, I did both. part-time at university and part-time at church as a pastor. On both environments, working with youth and teenagers. And it was a good experience, especially for my mental health. Because when I was somehow bored with church issues, and pastor usually got bored with that, because people in our church used to bother pastors. Yeah. So I went to university, and then there was a different environment with different issues, different challenges, and it was good for me. And the opposite as well. Sometimes in the university, things get hard and new coordinators and new policies, new procedures. And I was worried about my future there. And then I went to Sunday service or a long weekend camp with youth people. And that was so inspiring. That time I also thought about some situation that I think it is still happening. And in church and in business as well. So, at the beginning of this meeting, this morning, was said that this was just a start for a further conversations, right? So here is some ideas just to think, and you can disagree with me, not now, after. But I am very comfortable to share this stuff, thoughts with you. At that time, I saw that, in my opinion, the major flaw in church was about space. And the major flaw in business was about time. And you know that our life only happens in space and time. We at church, we think a lot, we talk a lot, but we didn't do a lot. And we always probably think that we should be prepared for heaven, as if heaven is not to happen in this space that we are now. And in business, on the contrary, we do a lot. And somebody somewhere make us believe that time is money. So we work, work, and work. And we miss the other dimension of time. We work if it will be no future. So we must do now. And we must do better. And we must do quickly. I remember when getting my undergrad in communication, I was in the last term. And with most of our my classmates, we are somehow concerned and complain that at university we didn't have too much practical experience. We would like to have a more hands-on program. And I remember a professor who said to us, here is the place to think. Here is the place to argue. Here is the place to question. Because when you get in the labor market, when you get in the company or whatever, they won't expect you to argue, to question, and to think. They will expect you to do, and do it right, and do it fast. So, probably, we should think about this. in the sense of church missing the space. Jesus said on that parable in Matthew 25:37, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, and thirst and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger, inviting you in or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison or God to visit you? Jesus was saying a parable about the future, about the heaven. But the king will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers here, not there, and sisters of mine, you did for me. And I would like to close with two citations. One of them is about A.W. Tozer, this pastor and writer was my inspiration during my first years of ministry. And I remember a book when he wrote, if half of our prayers that we pray, usually pray in Sunday morning services, should be answered, our world will be completely different. Because we pray, but we don't expect it, the prayer will be answered. So somehow we think about our faith and about our church to prepare us for heaven, but not something that should be happening now, in this moment, in this place. And the second reference is about a commercial. Some years ago, an American bank aired an advertisement campaign in São Paulo, in Brazil, trying to change a little bit its image before in front of the public. And one of the phrases that they put on a big billboards and even in magazines was a phrase like, work, common, work, common, work, common. But remember that commas means pauses. So we should think about our mission as Christians, as managers in the business environment. We should think, and in our faith, is my opinion, we should do more. Thank you.